Prime Minister Shehbaz Sharif has presided over a meeting of the Azad Jammu and Kashmir cabinet along with the AJK Prime Minister Chaudhry Anwarul Haq as the Pakistani Premier makes a day-long visit to the region. During the meeting, the Prime Minister announced an aid package for the martyrs of recent violent incidents in the region. He also emphasized that he has effectively raised the Kashmir issue at different international forums. The Prime Minister will also meet with Hurriyat leaders from Jammu and Kashmir to discuss the ongoing situation in the region. Later in the day, the Prime Minister will visit the Neelam Jhelum hydropower project, where he will receive a briefing on the project's progress. Deposed Premier and PTI founder Imran Khan appeared before a five-member larger bench of the Supreme Court, led by Chief Justice Qazi Faiz Issa. The hearing is related to the government's intra-court appeal against the court's decision to nullify NAB law amendments. Imran Khan appeared via video link from Rawalpindi's Adiyala Jail, where he is currently being held. Chief Justice Issa called Attorney General Mansoor Usman Awan and the government's counsel, Makhdoom Ali Khan, to the rostrum to begin the hearing. During today's proceedings, the court also ordered an investigation into the leak of an image showing Khan's court appearance via video link. It followed the bench's decision not to live stream the court's proceedings for the day. The Islamabad High Court has responded to a letter from Senator Faisal Wavda seeking disclosure of correspondence between then IHC Chief Justice Athar Minallah and Justice Babar Sattar about his citizenship. The court's registrar, on behalf of IHC Chief Justice Amir Farooq, said that lawyers being considered for elevation as judges are not asked regarding residency or citizenship of any other country. The court also clarified that such residency or citizenship is not a disqualification for a judge under the country's constitution. Wavda had written a letter to the IHC in April asking why a judge could have dual citizenship when assembly members can't, and has demanded that the Supreme Judicial Council intervene in the matter. The Met Office has forecast very hot weather for the southern and central parts of Pakistan for today. Karachi is also set to experience scorching weather with temperatures predicted to reach to 39 degrees Celsius and 79% humidity. It comes a day after temperatures surged to the season's record highs in Sindh province. The government of Pakistan has announced a decrease in the cost of petrol and high-speed diesel for the next 2 weeks. The new prices that take effect from today come in response to recent drops in global oil prices. Drivers will benefit from ₹15.39 per litre reduction in petrol, bringing the new price down to ₹273.1. Meanwhile, the price of high-speed diesel also sees a decrease of ₹7.88 per litre, with the new rate set at ₹274.08. The government also announced that the price reductions will also be applicable to light diesel oil and kerosene. Pakistan's stock market faced a slight dip during intraday trading, having reached an all-time high a day earlier. Prime Minister Shehbaz Sharif's push for privatization, the return of foreign investors and other positive data on manufacturing output, and the inclusion of National Bank of Pakistan in a key index further fueled investor optimism. Overall, the PSX performance reflects a combination of positive developments, with privatization plans playing a major role. The Pakistan cricket team reached England on Wednesday after playing a three-match series against Ireland, which they won 2-1, following their dominant performance in the last two T20s. The Pakistani team under the leadership of Babar Azam will play a four-match T20 series against England from May 22nd to 30th, which would be their last outing before the commencement of the T20 World Cup 2024. France declared a state of emergency in New Caledonia following deadly riots sparked by electoral reform, resulting in the deaths of three indigenous Kanak and a police official. The emergency measures, effective for 12 days, allow for the banning of gatherings and restrict movement on the island. The unrest began after a new bill was passed in Paris, enabling French residents living in New Caledonia for 10 years to vote in provincial elections, a move feared to undermine the Kanak vote. In response to the violence, 500 police officers were deployed to the island, schools were closed, and a curfew was imposed in the capital. French Prime Minister Gabriel Attal and Interior Minister Gerald Darmanin convened a crisis meeting to address the situation. Slovakia's Prime Minister Robert Fico is stable but his condition remains very serious after an assassination attempt on Wednesday. The 59-year-old was shot 5 times while meeting supporters in the central town of Handlova. He underwent several hours of emergency surgery and was in critical condition. Deputy Prime Minister Robert Kalinak said Robert Fico is not out of danger yet. His condition stabilized after surgery, but his injuries are still complicated and serious. Slovak media reported that the alleged attacker, a 70-year-old writer, has been charged with attempted murder. The International Court of Justice is set to hear South Africa's call to stop Israel's invasion of Rafah, which it describes as a genocidal operation threatening the very survival of Palestinians. South Africa's top lawyers will argue that the ICJ should order an immediate ceasefire throughout Gaza, citing the court's previous ruling in January that Israel must prevent genocidal acts and enable humanitarian aid to Gaza. The ICJ earlier stopped short of ordering a ceasefire, and South Africa is arguing that the situation on the ground requires fresh action. The Rafah operation has displaced an additional 600,000 Palestinians, and South Africa claims that Israel's actions are themselves genocidal. South Africa is urging the ICJ to order Israel to stop its invasion of Rafah and elsewhere in Gaza, citing the overwhelming evidence of the harm caused to Palestinians that includes 35,000 fatalities caused by Israel. 5 Israeli soldiers have been killed in the northern Gaza Strip when they were struck by fire from Israeli tanks. The Israeli military said the incident was caused by friendly fire from a tank and that it is carrying out further investigation. The deaths bring the number of Israeli soldiers killed since the start of the onslaught on Gaza to 626. Meta Platforms has restored Facebook posts by Malaysian media covering Prime Minister Anwar Ibrahim's meeting with a Hamas leader. Anwar had met Ismail Haniyeh of Hamas in Qatar on Monday. Malaysia's government had sent a letter to Meta asking for an explanation after the posts were removed. It also inquired about the closure of a Facebook account belonging to a media outlet that covers Palestinian issues. The removal of the posts drew complaints from Malaysia's government, which warned of firm action against Meta and other social media companies. Meta claimed the posts were removed in an error. Social media has responded unfavorably to King Charles III's first official portrait since his coronation last year. The portrait depicts the monarch adorned in the ceremonial red attire of the Welsh Guard set against a backdrop of red. While many critics focused on the hideous nature of the red tones, others saw similarities between the monarch and satanic imagery. The NFL has released its 2024 schedule with the 18-week 272-game season, kicking off on September 5th. Key games of the schedule include the Kansas City Chiefs hosting the Baltimore Ravens in a rematch of the AFC Championship game. Meanwhile, the Philadelphia Eagles and Green Bay Packers will play the first ever NFL game in South America on September 6th. Furthermore, NFL's Tom Brady kicks off his broadcasting career this season by calling the Cleveland Browns versus Dallas Cowboys game on September 8th. Ben Affleck and Jennifer Lopez are reportedly on the brink of divorce, less than 2 years after tying the knot. A source close to the couple revealed that they just couldn't make it work, signaling an end to their rekindled romance. This development follows reports that Affleck has already moved out of their shared $60 million home, with Lopez spotted house hunting in Beverly Hills alone. According to The Insider, Affleck is now prioritizing his work and his kids as the couple faces the reality of selling their dream home, a property they spent 2 years searching for.